Welcome to New Fero Stadium, home of the Snuffalo Thrills. The city's tourism slogan, shuffle off to Snuffalo and die. It's very appropriate as the Thrills fans are eager to see their opponents buried today.
Very popular honeymoon spot, too, Grim. When the honeymoon's over, do what those people do. Jump off the floors with the old ball and chain.
Hey, anybody see my good smokes?
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The New Yuck Threats battle. The Snuffalo Thrills. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hello again, everybody. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
That's me.
And his mutant hobbit head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
How about you shut the fuck up?
Well played, Jr. Moving on. And it's first and ten. The offensive water with strawberry pitcher taking what the defense has given them. That's a 4-yard gain on the reception.
Hey, less than a wipe for the headed.
Second down and six. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and ten.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and ten. Quarterback drills one in for the first down. First down and one. Second and three. And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Touchdown! Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Do we have a rule book?
It's propping up your chair so you can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
Second down and a lot. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Was way off target, but I'm pretty sure the QB will blame the receiver as he always does. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And get ready for the kick. This isn't a gimme. Wow, surprised me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten.
A boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And that'll bring up third down and seven. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. And he breaks away. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and five. Laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and ten. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and seven.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. The brutal hit. And it's first and ten. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Nice run for 5 yards. Third down and three. And this game is up for grabs. Third down and three. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and ten. Oh.
it's a good fit. I think the ginormous guy is compensating for something.
Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. He's at the 30. The 20. He's at the 10. Do that again, Bricks. I'll shoot you in the head.
The people like it.
And these guys think kicking is for pussies, Bricks. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Glenn.
Yeah, bigger than yours.
And he runs it in for an easy 2 points. The momentum in this game may be shifting.
Oh, those are just my balls.
Hey, thanks for sharing, Bricks. Hey, man, nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. Quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws a supersonic missile.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And it's first and 10. If he is getting killed by a chain, he's a bucket list on his bucket list. He can cross that off. Oh, killer hit, literally. I love how they explode into a shower of blood and guts.
Yeah, the pieces of him are flying into the cheap seats.
And it's first and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And that'll be second and 8 to go. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Third down and 8. And this guy is supercharged with electricity. Oh, he fumbled that one. Everyone loves being on the highlight reel, leaping over a defender, but sometimes you get hit hard and have the ball knocked loose. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. But, my friend, was an all-pro. MFL hit. Second and three. Third down and five.
Congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and ten. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Second down and 10. He is fighting for every yard.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And it's first and 10. And that pass play is good for 8 yards. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
Second down and 2. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing in the hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused.
Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Whoa. And the defense puts one over on the quarterback with a sticky ball dirty trick. The only thing the QB can do now is run for his life.
Or die.
Hey, man, I'm scared of a shiver. I am a hell of a shiver.
Third down, and they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. Third down, and the punter is warming up. This guy's going to get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. And they'll line up for the punt here. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does
And that's the end of the second quarter. Seminole will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. The teams line up for the kickoff to start the second half. These guys will have to play a lot harder to make it a game. Well, either that or kill and cheat more. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10. Oh, I love this dirty trick. Feet. Oh, welcome to Fumble Town USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles. He scores! He earned those points on the heels of an epic run.
Don't call things epic, Grim. Kids aren't going to think you're cool no matter what you do.
Junior, I don't want kids to think I'm cool. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. With the brutal hit. Second down and 5. First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and 10. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. The offense just burned the defense pretty hard on that one.
That is still edible, though. Just got to scrape off the charred parts.
Third down, and, well, good luck. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. Boring, but smart. Time to punt. Man, oh man, they lined up and faked it.
Just like my third ex-wife.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit.
No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
And here comes the extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And he just wrestles away from that tackle. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
It's first and 10. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely at a convo wasn't home.
Second and 3. They've used a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Those guys don't know which way forward is. Nicely done for a first down. It's first and 10. Second down in a mile. A nice catch for 5 yards. Third down and long. He blasted and picks up 7 yards right there. This kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
He's got the distance, and the kick is good.
If you get one more bullshit penalty, you get one more for free.
You'll also probably lose the game. Just do the attack ref dirty trick.
Jumps on sides and attacks the ref. And the ref runs out of bounds and manages to survive somehow.
Yeah, at least for another 40 seconds.
Man, these guys have metal. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. He boomed that one. Let's see if they... He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, with a punishing hit. And it's first and 10. Simple game when it comes down to it. And It's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. Second down and long. They pick up a nice chunk of yards on that pass play. Third down and 3. Gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. First and 4. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Third and 4. And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. Why is it that no one can score in this league without showboating? And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. And that play went nowhere fast. No gain. Second down and 10. And that's a sack. The quarterback has to get rid of the ball there.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
Third down and forever.
I'm pretty sure my baby sister can throw further than that. But she doesn't have to play against goddamn monsters.
You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. Let's see if he beats the... Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. And that is caught for a first down. And it's first and 10. Wow, the quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver, knocking down the entire defense. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
touch an eyeball, I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Well, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10.
It's a jab attack.
Devastating hit knocks the ball loose. The defense is relentless out there, and they get the turnover. And like bricks his bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Well, it's all fun and games until he tries breakdancing.
Yep. With skeletons, it's always more literal.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. Well, that's 2 timeouts burned, and you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Grim, but it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. First down and 9. It's 2-yard run before he stopped. Second down and 7. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. That is a lousy kickoff. The offense is going to have great field position. First and 10. sandwich. And it's first and 10. We're at the end of the fourth quarter, and the score is tied, and that means overtime. It's a brand new game now. There's more blood on the field than players at this point, Bricks. Bricks, overtime is a war with some basic rules. The first touchdown wins the game, but if the team that receives the kickoff gets a field goal, then the other team is allowed a possession too. After that, whomever scores wins.
Grandma, I didn't understand any of that. Can you repeat it?
Not a chance. Trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Second down and 7.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. That's a 6-yard gain on that catch. And that'll be second down and 4. Oh, nice hit! First down and 1. And the ball is lateral to and into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downers guy than a speed freak, friend. He's running from his demons, it's clear.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you'll go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
The Snuffle Thrills, Thriller Home fans, and walk away with a victory. That was one hell of a slugfest. That was worth the price of admission, right, guys?
Why pay for admission? I expect girls dancing on a pole or something.
Girls win. How about a lap dance?
You don't even have a lap, you little freakazoid.
Call me.
Let's see what the MVP has to say about today's outcome. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.